Say yes to new beginnings.
Yes.
Say yes to new standards of excellence.
Yes.
Say yes to engaging reportage with a difference.
Yes.
Introducing Yes International Magazine.
Now, you have talked about your most memorable. Can we talk about your most embarrassing outing as a public speaker?
My most embarrassing outing, it wasn't my making, but nothing worked. The microphones did not work. The mics were, you know, they had a mind of their own. You know, the hall was hot. The audience was inattentive. I just couldn't string it together, you know. But yes, I wasn't happy at the end of the day. But well, I just accepted that, well, this is one of those bad days. Yeah.
So anytime you're faced, or you come face to face with a difficult audience, how do you wriggle out of it?
Because it happens all of the time, you know. We talk about controlling your stage first, controlling the audience. Now, there are times when you probably find that your audience is inattentive, or maybe one or two of them are nodding off, possibly you are boring, and I hope not. What happens is, one of the surest ways, and which has worked for me, is the use of the pause. I use the pause effectively. It's like you're in full flight with your speech, and all of a sudden you stop. When you notice that people are not listening, you just pause for 1, 2, 3, 4 seconds. And of course, automatically, those people who are not listening to you, or who are just passively listening to you, would notice that you've stopped speaking, and then they immediately come back to you. So that's a technique that we use, all right? Another technique that we use is engaging the audience. You can ask them questions, right? You can ask them for a show of hands, so you're able to bring them all back to the table. So there are so many things that we do, but one of the most effective, like I said, is the use of the pause. The pause is magical.
Now, as a professional public speaker and coach, you know, how do you feel anytime you come across people who are poor, terrible, horrible public speakers?
I feel sorry for them and the audience. I feel sorry for them and I feel sorry for their audience, because you'll find that half of the time they're in self-denial. You know, they don't want to accept that they have a problem. Okay, and some of them truly don't even know that they're not doing it right. So when I meet people like that, if I am able to approach them and simply point out one or two things to them and get them to seek assistance, fine. That doesn't happen all of the time, because most times you never get the opportunity to do that. But when I encounter people who are unable to deliver well, deliver right, you know, I feel pity for the audience, because, yeah, I mean, the audience really doesn't deserve, you know, a poor showing.
Now, are there precautionary steps or things, you know, that any serious public speaker must take, you know, prior to climbing the stage, or prior to mounting the stage, or prior to taking over the microphone? And that's some precautionary thing.
I've highlighted some of them, but I'll go over them again. Never take any engagement for granted. You have to prepare. That's the first rule. Never take any engagement for granted. Make sure you know your stuff. Make sure that you are ready for the audience. If possible, go to the venue a day or two ahead of the event, all right? So that you know the place, you feel the place. again, acclimatize yourself. That's two. Three, work on your mindset. Your mindset is very important. Prime yourself ready. Think positive. Believe in yourself. Accept within yourself that you're going to have a good day. So, and you're likely to have a good day. Leave your what ifs at the door. Leave your doubts at the door. And when you get up there, make sure that you immediately connect with your audience. Tell them a story. You know, make them know you're human. Make yourself vulnerable. Put them on the same plate with you, right? And then speak clearly and concisely. They say that if you speak too much, it means that you don't know what you're saying, right? So measure your words. Don't talk too much. Listen with your eyes, okay? Listen with your eyes. That means you have to look at your audience, figure out if they are with you or if you have lost them along the line, all right? Again, let's go back to one of the errors that people make when they are given opportunities to speak. You're given, you've prepared a presentation for like 20 minutes and you're only allowed 10 minutes. Okay, so you find that, in 10 minutes you may not be able to go through all that you have. The tendency is for us to want to rush through all the slides that you prepared for 20 and make it fit into 10. That is a huge mistake. What you can do is, you know, make your presentation a little more concise. Edit your presentation, okay? Fit it into 10 minutes. And then any information that you are not able to pass across, let them have your contact, you know, at question time or at the end. Let them know that, yes, you can get further information on this if you reach me here. All right, so don't rush. Don't speed. We have speed limits to speeches, to speech making. There are speed limits. And if you overspeed, just like when you're driving a car and you hit a bump, you're likely to have an accident. So maintain your natural speed. Don't overspeed. Stay within the speed limit. Don't break the red lights, okay? Otherwise, you may get arrested for it. Yeah, so, yeah, those are some of the things, yeah.
Okay.